इज गायनेक शुड मैरी अ मेडिकल। वैसे तो दोस्तों सबसे बड़ा सवाल यह है कि गायनेक ने शादी करनी चाहिए या नहीं। खैर ये तो आपने अपने पति देव ही बता पाएंगे। एनीवेज देखते हैं कि अगले डिबेटर्स क्या सलाह देते हैं। टू से फॉर द टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट द फर्स्ट डिबेटर डॉक्टर रिया मंतानी। डॉक्टर रिया हैज रिसीव इंटेंसिव ट्रेनिंग इन मैनेजमेंट ऑफ हाई रिस्क ऑब्स्टेट्रिक्स फ्रॉम KEM हॉस्पिटल एंड हैज पोस्ट डॉक्टरल डिग्री इन मिनिमल इन्वेसिव गायनेकोलॉजी। शी हैज ऑल्सो कम्प्लीटेड सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स इन वजाइनल एस्थेटिक्स एंड कॉस्मेटिक गायनेकोलॉजी। डॉक्टर रिया इज अ स्कॉर्पियो। स्कॉर्पियो पीपल आर डीपली इमोशनल एंड सेंसिटिव। स्कॉर्पियोज आर द मोस्ट लॉयल फ्रेंड्स एंड मोस्ट एम्बिशियस। दे हैव अ पावरफुल प्रेजेंस एंड डिमांडिंग पर्सनालिटीज। ओवर टू यू रिया।
Thank you, ma'am, for the wonderful introduction, and thank you, Alka, ma'am, and team energies for giving me this opportunity. My topic is very interesting. Should a gynecologist marry a medico? And I agree with madam, the basic question starts with should a gynecologist marry a doctor? Anyhow, we proceed considering the gynecologist should marry. So, my first slide is why do we want to think over this? Because marriages in India have been always a very, very important institution, and once you are married, usually you are committed for life. The milieu at home determines how you will work at your workplace, and it also has an impact on one's physical and emotional well-being. Changing either your spouse or your profession is a very, very scary thing. So it has to be a well-thought decision. Let's look at the statistics. Around 90% of doctors get married, 10% prefer not to fall into this trap. Around 69% prefer being married to another doctor, and 31% of doctors rejected the notion of having a doctor as their spouse, stating that the same hectic work schedule makes it difficult to cope with the family pressures. However, Sobeck et al., this is a study from PubMed, they have studied dual doctor families with a physician marrying a non-doctor, and have concluded that the dual doctor's families earned less money, they less often felt that the career took precedence over the spouse's career, and more often played a major role in childbearing. These differences were greater for a female physician than a male physician. They were similar for the other group in terms of the goals in the career that they achieved and goals for their children, and with which they felt conflict between professional and family roles. So they say that all the rate of conflict among both the groups is same, the achieved career goals is the same, the career goals achieved for the children is same. So why do doctors prefer to marry a doctor? They spend most of their time together. It's a 20-year long affair with studies. So 8 years after you pass your 12th standard, practically you are studying in the medical school. You do not have many other friends outside your medical fraternity. Do not have many hobbies to cultivate and take care of, and when you are going through a grill and challenges which other person is also going through, you feel a sense of belonging and better understanding with that person. There is not much need to explain the demanding nature of our profession to someone in the same field, and doctors are generally more or less better organized and better at taking decisions than any other professionals. So you know, yahi hai right choice for you. Now, I talked to few of my friends, gynecologists who married medicos and gynecologists who married non-medicos. I'll be speaking about people who married medicos. Expectation, they say that expectations of taking care of the household chores are much more, and you cannot explain to them why you cannot do it. There is practically no healthy decision making, either on professional front or career decisions. They always feel, अरे तुम तो बहुत पैसे बना लेती होगी या बना लेते होंगे, and they never accept any possible financial crunch. If you fall ill, they are the ones who get scared, so you are never on the pampering end. They are more scared, and you have to play the brave one, even if it is you who is ill. They can never gauge the day-to-day stress of a medico-legal issue, and are clueless why you are so paranoid about PCPNDT, consent, and you have nightmares of maternal mortality all the time. You cannot explain why if there is a social function to attend at 10 p.m. at 9 and a laboring patient comes at 7, why don't you do a straight away C-section and be free for the night? You cannot explain then why. There is nothing like unplanned holidays for us. and you get tired explaining them why you cannot have one. You come home after a heroic day dealing with, you know, things like placenta, accreta, PPH, but no one really understands the efforts, risks, or the courage behind it. The spouse may be very, very uncomfortable when you take him or her to a medical gathering, and it may be a task making them be friends with your friends. Now, what makes a medico a perfect match for a gynecologist? This is from my friends who married a doctor. Now, during medical training, each of us is grilled, beaten, and chiseled to make the most adaptable creature in the world. We learn to adapt to every possible non-human working condition and also learn self-dependency skills like cooking, washing, cleaning, etc. We understand the stress of taking the responsibility of a human life. And we also have a deep sense of empathy and a compassionate way of looking at things. A medical spouse can apply reason why his or her spouse is not able to give in the same amount of time, share as many responsibilities, or carry on the stereotyped gender-associated roles. If workplace happens to be the same, like mine, the couple can share their tensions, sort out difficulties, and spend more time together in the workplace. They are able to give us a more sound professional advice when needed. And we can explain our almost always many relatives as to why certain expectations of the conventional society cannot be fulfilled by us in the conventional manner. So, you know, when you look at them, that's the expression you get. Kya baat hai? This is about my experience. I am married to a pediatric endocrinologist who happens to be my MBBS attachment. We have known each other for long, long years, and we both recognize and appreciate each other's weaknesses and strengths, and can relate to the struggles of establishing our practice. We envision for one another higher goals in academics and encourage each other to attain them. We know our responsibilities towards our family, towards each other, towards our son, and share an excellent chemistry and of course physics to balance the work and life. So he is the man standing by my side and not behind me, strong, with more faith in me than myself, the one who makes chasing my dreams easier for me. Experience is the best teacher, and from my experience, I conclude that a gynecologist, if she or he chooses to marry, should always marry another doctor or medico. I want to acknowledge my dear friends, Dr. Shraddha Verma Thakur, Dr. Amini Khare, Dr. Pallavi Joshi, Dr. Nilofar Surti, and Dr. Karanjit Kaur for their valuable inputs. As well, I want to acknowledge Dr. Alka Mukherjee ma'am, Dr. Ashish Kukhe sir, and Team Energies for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Ria. To say against, I invite Dr. Rupali Deshpande. Dr. Rupali is a Virgo. Virgo people are humble, self-efficient, industrious, and practical, but natural, kind, and sympathetic. They utilize their sharp intellect to win debates and people's hearts and minds. Dr. Rupali is a director at Ishita Clinic, Nagpur. Her special interest is in infertility, gynec obstetrics, and ultrasound. She has received the BD Shastra Gold Medal. Over to you, Rupali.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Alka Mukherjee ma'am, for giving me this part of the debate. Since yesterday we are going through lots and lots of academics, so this is a total twist in the academic. My topic is gynec should marry a medico. Now, does a lawyer marry a lawyer? Does an engineer marry an engineer? Or does a businessman marry a businesswoman? It's not mandatory. But when it comes to doctor, why does everyone suggest that a doctor should marry a doctor? I totally disagree with this concept. Let's see how is the life of a medico. Imagine a cold winter morning and you are planning to have a cup of coffee with your husband. Suddenly his phone rings. It's an emergency and he has to rush in. You are left all alone pondering over the coffee. Now this becomes a routine, day in and day out, and you get used to this type of life. Now let's see how is the life of a gynecologist. That picture is not there to scare you. Actually, there are no words to describe the life of a gynecologist.
To say against, I invite Dr. Urdu people are humble, self-sufficient, industrious and practical, but natural, kind and sympathetic. They utilize their sharp intellect to win debates and people's hearts and minds. Dr. Rupali is the director at Ishita Clinic, Nagpur. Her special interest is in infertility, Harris obstetrics and ultrasound. She has received the BD Shastrakar Gold Medal. Over to you, Rupali.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Dr. Alka Mukherjee ma'am, for giving me this part of the debate. Since yesterday we are going through lots and lots of academics, so this is a total twist in the academic. My topic is Gynae should marry a medico. Now, does a lawyer marry a lawyer? Does an engineer marry an engineer? Or does a businessman marry a businesswoman? It's not mandatory. But when it comes to doctor, why does everyone suggest that a doctor should marry a doctor? I totally disagree with this concept. Let's see how is the life of a medico. Imagine a cold winter morning and you are planning to have a cup of coffee with your husband. Suddenly his phone rings. It's an emergency and he has to rush in. You are left all alone pondering over the coffee. Now this becomes a routine, day in and day out, and you get used to this type of life. Now let's see how is the life of a gynecologist. That picture is not there to scare you. Actually, there are no words to describe the life of a gynecologist. You are busy 24/7 and all the time at your toes for your patient. Now in the OPD, usually everyone sees you with a very happy smiling face. But what goes on inside you is a turmoil of thoughts. And while taking care of your OPD, your OT, your emergency, and at the same time balancing your family life is really a tough task for a gynecologist. It's just like walking on that thin road. When it comes to a woman, she's expected to do multitasking. Along with taking care of her career, she has to take care of her children. She has to be techno savvy. She has to do all her household work. She has to complete her social responsibilities. And above all, everyone expects her to smile at the end of the day, which is actually not practical. So this leads to some amount of guilt, some amount of frustration and depression. This is the right time when you need your partner. Now your partner, being a medico, in spite of he wishes to give you some time, he fails to because he's already preoccupied with work. When it comes to marriage, it's a stereotypical thinking that a doctor should marry a doctor, and this thought has percolated from one generation to another. And I think Riya has wisely told all the reasons for this. But the main thing is that if you work together, your bonding increases. But I have a list why you should not marry a medico. Now you see this picture where you can see a couple on a date, but both they are busy in their mobiles attending their patients. They don't have time for each other. Now weekend is such a word which should be erased from the dictionary of a medico because we don't have any weekends. And when we plan to, it's the Saturday evening when some bad patient is referred in your OPD or some patient lags into some complication and it ruins your weekend. Coming to vacations, we go for vacation maybe once or twice in a year, and those are well planned in advance, maybe 3 or 4 months before, so that we can adjust all our patients. You cannot have a family dinner together, which is a very simple pleasure of life. Then you become an expert in giving multiple excuses to your family. Then your husband is unable to attend the gatherings. And being common workplace, to some extent there is a lack of privacy. Now there are certainly advantages of marrying a non-medico. There is a well-known proverb, opposites attract each other. Now these opposites are in terms of their personality, in thinking and also in career. It has been studied that opposites, they don't only attract, but they also tend to stay together for a long while. Gynecologists usually live in a closed environment, unaware of the exciting facets of life, such as sports, travel, understanding spirituality and art. But if your husband is a non-medico and has got different interests and hobbies, it would help you enrich your experience. He will be the person who will tell you that other than Pitocin, think of traveling to Paris. Other than prostaglandins and PPA, there is an Okinawa island in Japan which needs to be explored. Doctor is a very deep and honorable profession, and when a medico enters in a non-medico family, he or she gets huge appreciation and respect. You don't carry your day mingles back to your dinner table, and you have very interesting topics to talk about, just as your hobbies, passion, and your dreams. Variety is the spice of life. To the same problem, you can have a solution in a different way. The final and the most important is the settlement. Medicos, they usually settle by 35 years of age or maybe even after that. So when you and your husband both are medico, you stay in the same because you both are financially unstable. Whereas if you marry a non-medico, he's already settled by 27 years of age. When he reaches by 40 years of age, he's almost in the plans of his retirement. But what makes a successful marriage? It's definitely not the career. It's a mutual understanding and cooperation for each other. And I think we have been seeing this with Dr. Alka Mukherjee ma'am and Dr. Arup sir since yesterday. And they really portray a perfect mate for each other couple. These are the two famous couples where a non-medico has married a medico. And here, in spite of their different professions, they are together living happily and contented since so many years. Also, their partners, they have achieved excellence in their fields and also win Padma Shri Award. Before I sum up my topic, I would like to throw light on these two famous personalities. Dr. Anandibai Joshi, who is the first female physician of India, and Dr. Kadambini Ganguly, who is the first female gynecologist of India. Now both these ladies, they had non-medico husband, but in spite of that, they could pave a path on which we are traveling now, and also they could reach the heights of their careers. So when these two ladies, they can marry a non-medico, why can't we, today's generation girls, think of marrying a non-medico? So life is all about choices. As all of you, I am also married to a medico. Happily. But if given a chance, ma'am, I would love to have stayed completely different profession.
Thank you so much.